Hey, this is Gunsully. I'm here in the cell phone lot at Dulles. I'm waiting to get a fare. I'm rocking my Slants bracelet here, along with one of my Food of Warrior Project bracelets. And this nice purple shirt that my lovely wife bought for me. I feel like Lyft royalty. I feel gorgeous. I feel like I'm Peacock Supreme. You know, there's definitely a peacocking outfit. If anybody doesn't know what peacocking is, you should look into that. It's awesome. Okay, so I just wanted to kind of chill. I wanted to chill out and listen to some Fellowcraft before I start. Let me take my glasses off. So I wanted to talk to you. And talk to the world here. About the North Korea issue. Let's see here. Don't register. We're gonna play some Crazy Taxi. Let's talk about the North Korea issue, shall we? Just kidding, I don't wanna talk about North Korea. For antisocialnews.com, we might do a big special on North Korea, but I'm not going to talk about that. I want to talk about music, because that's what the podcast is all about now, is music. And we're going to talk to you about the Slants. The Slants are still fighting their court case. You know what? I feel like the sound effects for this game is unnecessary. I need to turn the sound effects off. Let's see if we can do that. Settings. I have one notch on there. There we go. Cool. So we can hear Fellowcraft playing in the background. Okay. Cool. Resume this because I really want to talk about the Slants. Now, a lot of you know that I ran off to go see the Slants in Philadelphia, which was a pretty epic show. It was sort of funny. The Slants play for all sorts of lawyer audiences nowadays because they have gained a lot of notoriety and attention from UCLA and ACLU and the Cato Institute and other free speech forums liberal rights and civil liberties institutes. So they've been playing in a lot of forums like that around America. Man, I'm not doing good at this game today. You know, I'm too used to driving normally, and this is not about driving normally. This is about driving crazy. So I'm trying to get into the crazy taxi mode of driving. And you know, it is very hard because I think like, oh, I need to be maintaining my lane because that's how I drive normally, maintaining my lane. Anyway, let's think about that night when I went up to Philadelphia. It was actually really cool because I go up there and I picked up a Lyft fare on my way up. That was cool. I went to the airport, the Philadelphia International Airport, and I picked up a fare and took the nice people into Philadelphia. And very sweet people, very nice ride. That Philadelphia International Airport, super busy. It told me I was 32nd in queue. And I basically pulled in, I start to adjust my bags, get a fare, like that. So when bursts of passengers come in, they come in hardcore. Just to let you know when I started recording, I was 20th in queue, now I'm 15th. So that's pretty fast, but it's nothing compared to Philadelphia International Airport. So I go to the venue, and I look at the Slant schedule, and apparently I missed them at a few things, and they were at PIPLA, P-I-P-L-A, which is some legal association in Philadelphia. So I was like, you know what? I can't make it to that. I'm just going to go stake out the venue. I go get a cup of coffee, and I'm at the venue that they're going to be playing, Kung Fu Necktie. And I love Kung Fu Necktie after seeing some shows there, but I got to tell you, just going there, I'm thinking this band, the Slants, they are nationwide. They are, they're holding their own, you know, when it comes to publicity and venues. And here they are playing second fiddle to some local band in Philadelphia at this little hole in the wall venue. And I thought, man, these guys have done three other events in that same day. In the morning, they were at Museum. Then they went to Villanova. Then they went to PIPLA. And they're doing shows every single time. Sorry. Needs to be motion. All right. Every time they're doing a venue, they actually do a show. So these guys have been performing three times in one day. And I'm thinking the fourth venue is this little hole in the wall venue. I thought they're not even going to want to do this. And not to mention it being like a hole in a wall, but there was four other bands playing at Kung Fu Necktie. Future Computre. I'm going to put links to these other bands too, because they were all awesome. Future Computre, Overcoming Gravity, and VOLTHEQUE were also playing that same day. And the dance area was where everybody had to pile all of their equipment. So the dance area was taken up about 50-50 by equipment. The other half is where people would be, you know, awkwardly standing amongst bags and boxes of musical equipment from these four bands. It kind of reminded me of, if you've seen Portlandia, the barbecue episode, the 4th of July punk rock barbecue episode, it reminded me of that. And I remember thinking, these guys aren't even going to want to play here. And of course, when they showed up, these guys were dead tired. And they sort of, funny, awkward part about the venue as well was the back door was like bolted shut, so all the bands had to bring in their equipment through the front door. So imagine four bands bringing equipment in through the front door of a building the size of an apartment, having to go around the pool table to carry their stuff in. It seemed like this funny, kind of awkward place. And I thought, there's no way these guys might just cancel. They might take one look at this thing and cancel. And the funniest part about it was Simon walks in and just goes, "Oh, this is great. This reminds us of Portland." And it just sort of hit me. I was like, oh yeah, Portland. This is like their roots, is like playing in little clubs like this in Portland. And those guys were so at home and just so comfortable and just like chill in this little tiny venue. After playing for a bunch of stuffed shirts at PIPLA, these guys are just like totally at home in a dive bar in Philly, under a bridge in Philly, Kung Fu Necktie. And that's where they felt really, really chill. And it just shows you what cool musicians these guys are. They really are. They are absolute showmen, great musicians. I tell the story about them playing a mini concert for babies on the Supreme Court steps. Got the YouTube video of that, so that'll be in the description of this. just want to give a shout out to the Slants for being so great. Also, shout out to Fellowcraft, who are playing right at the moment. You can hear JR singing his soulful song about glass houses, which do a good interview with him on that. Let's see here. What else should I talk to you about with thepodcast.com? thepodcaste.com. And I want to try to keep an eye on my place in queue. I'm trying to keep an eye on my place in queue. Play this game and tell you about everything we got going on with the podcast. I am trying to get a hold of the former head of Dead End Kidz, which was a band in Baltimore that had some venues and some original music there, and they took a break and they are coming back. Are you kidding? Wow, I jumped quite a bit. No, that's not. That's not. Not from the damn. I did not miss a request. It's not an airport request. This thing just tried to hook me up with somebody from Reston. 10 minutes away and Reston. I'm in the airport lot. I'm not supposed to get ferries from there. Lyft, get your crap together. Holy crap. I'm not going to go to Reston to pick up Yolanda. I am in the cell phone lot at it put me to the back of the queue. I was 7th in queue, and it just put me to the back of the queue to punish me for not picking up Yolanda, who was not even in the airport. I'm only supposed to be getting fares from the airport. That's what the queue is. It keeps you from getting outside of the airport fares. I'm in the queue. I was 7th in queue, and it just knocked me back to 33rd in queue to punish me for not getting an illicit fare. I shouldn't have even got that fare request. Cliff, get your crap together. Gee whiz. Lyft. Honestly. This is why you're number two. Because you have crap with your app and your system, and you don't fix it. I thought you guys fixed this crap. Because this happened to me all Monday of last week. I came here Monday of last week, and I just got fare request after fare request after fare request from outside areas, which is not, I'm not supposed to be getting those. And yeah, they punished me every time for not taking, you know, some person from outside of the airport to some other place outside of the airport. It's not. It's ridiculous, and yeah, honestly, get your crap together. You're an international company. Oh my gosh, this priest is not gonna be happy how many car accidents I'm getting into. But I gotta get him to the church on time. Get me to the church on time. It wasn't really my David Bowie impersonation, but hey, it's the Slants. I love Ken Shima's voice. He has such a great voice. And I know I just said how soulful and great J.R. McDonald of Fellowcraft's voice is, but you know what? There is love in my heart. For more than one, I'll dare say even more than two artists. I might, if this podcast goes long enough, I might say something nice about Chris Bubulia's voice from one of the other bands featured on this mix. He is the lead singer of. Oh no! He is the lead singer of My favorite local dance band. I'm sorry to jam you in the category of dance music there, Chris, but I think Dr. Badlove and the Remedies is like fun dance music. See, like, so if I'm going to have to separate my love for Fellowcraft and my love for you, I would say Fellowcraft is rock, and you're more dancey dance. But you know, he said he doesn't want to be put in a category, and I understand that. He is an artist. Chris, you're an artist. I respect your wish to not be shoved into a category, but I will say that your music is fun and it makes me want to dance, and that's why I'm calling it dance music. The Slants call themselves Chinatown Dance Rock. Oh, I want to pick up that fair, but I'm like right in front of him. There we go. Get, oh no! Sorry, I didn't mean to hit you. I'm just trying to pick you up. I'm not good at WASD. WASD is when you're playing on a keyboard and you use WASD. I'm not good at that. I'm not good at that. I grew up with that, but for some reason I have forgotten how to WASD. WASD. Okay. Oh my goodness, where have I gone? I gotta go up the stairs. Holy crap. Holy crap, holy crap, holy crap. Oh no! Oh no, I missed my turn. Oh, this is a bad rating. This is gonna be a bad rating. He is not gonna rate me. Well, I need to make up. Come on, I gotta get this man to where he needs to go. Oh, I'm not gonna make it. He is gonna get out of my car. Ah, oh, this is horrible. No! Oh, it was a she. That was bad on me too for not noticing the gender of the polygons that I was driving around. Come on, polygons. Come on. Come on, 2004 polygons. Sutures, I love this song. This song is so great. And I had a good interchange with oh gosh, I had a good interchange with the Slants on their Twitter about this song, because it's just so heartbreaking. Such a legit sad song, so full of a lot of powerful emotion and a lot of imagery, and had a good interchange with them on Twitter about it, talking about how Simon mentioned it was actually about how he lost a friend. And yeah, I said that's I think you get to our age, you've lost a friend or two, and it's a hard situation to deal with. You gotta kind of rationalize it to stay sane, and yeah, very sad. Not really a crazy taxi song though, so I might have to change this song. Sorry. Sorry. I've got to move this on. I can't cry and play Crazy Taxi at the same time. Sorry. Okay, here we go. Back to it. Okay. That's not Crazy Taxi. There we go. I only have 15 seconds to get him where he needs to go. Oh, he's really close. He is not pleased. So, let's see here. Whoa, what am I doing? Holy crap, that was cool. So I'm looking to do an interview with Chris Bavoya of Dr. Badlove and the Remedies, hopefully with the whole band, the Remedies, and next Wednesday. That's what I'm hoping. I'm hoping to be able to crash one of their practice sessions so that I can get a little interview with both Chris and the rest of the band. Man, that's a lot of traffic right there. Oh, cool. I like that. That was a speedy trip. I didn't think I was going to make that one, honestly. Okay. All right. So here we go. I really want to get interviews with some of these other bands that I saw in Philadelphia. And this is fun. Oh, my gosh. I like wrecking these other cars. Woo-hoo. I think she likes that too. Yeah, she's enjoying that. She's a psychopath. All right. Boosh. Got thumbs up for that. I appreciate that. Okay. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Hey, buddy. How are you? Hey, brother, how are you? I'm too distracted by the gameplay at the moment to even think. So my wish list for bands to interview is Dead End Kidz, Dr. Badlove and the Remedies, VOLTHEQUE, Future Computre, Overcoming Gravity. Who else do I really want to interview? Catherine Reese. I want to interview her. She is a local funny singer. She sings funny songs. I enjoy her singing. So I would very much appreciate to chat with her. Sorry if I'm shaking the camera. You know what? You know what? I should try to put this up here. This is where I should try to. Wow! Look at that. Oh no. What am I doing? Oh gosh. Is that on there? It's so almost. Could you get on there? Oh, this is my favorite. This is my favorite one of their songs. It's secretly about Jessica Jones and Luke Cage. Simon explained that to me in my last podcast with Simon. So check that out. Listen to the whole podcast. Like, comment, and subscribe. Like, comment, subscribe, and give us $10,000 for our iHeartRadio ad campaign. That's right. For just a mere donation of $10,000, you could get us a partnership with iHeartRadio. Isn't that awesome? Can we do that? Can we give us $10,000? You give us $10,000, we'll say thank you. You won't get that from everybody. Some people, you give them $10,000 and they're like, $10,000, why not $20,000? But if you give us $10,000, we'll say thank you. So keep that in mind. The podcast, ThePodcaste, the podcast, the indefensible middle ground, the class of pod, thepodcast.com. We'll thank you for your $10,000 donation. And you know what? I'm going to go ahead and say thank you in advance, because I know you are currently writing us a check for $10,000. And I thank you from the bottom of my heart. You are so benevolent. And, you know, I'm just impressed that you did it so quickly. So thank you, kind person. I don't know if you're a male or female, so I can't. And I shouldn't judge you. Judge your gender, since gender is fluid. Thank you, Bill Nye. We'll tell you next week. Oh no, I almost hit a tree. Woo! Okay. Holy crapola. You see my how's my driving, huh? You like when I smash cars off the side of the road? Oh, that person almost died. Holy crapola. Normal. After all that, it was a normal fare. I jumped two car carrier semi-trucks. I don't think that was normal. I think that was abnormal. I think that was a crazy taxi ride. You know, since it is crazy taxi, normal shouldn't be normal. It should be crazy. I should say that. It should at least acknowledge that it was a crazy taxi ride. Normal. So insulting. I'm so insulted. I'm affected. I'm so offended by this. How dare it call my driving normal? I ran over people in the name of a speedy ride. Boom. Okay. So, reaching out to, bands to interview. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and say a fun story. Nothing to do with anything. This morning, I tried to wake up super early, and I got some caffeine in my system, and then I went right back to sleep. You know what happens when you go back to sleep on lots and lots of caffeine? It's weird dreams. Just weird ass dreams. Tons and tons and tons of them. Yeah, I had a weird morning. There was a warrant for my arrest? It wasn't. It was just a super realistic dream where I was a bad guy for some reason. I'm not a good person. But like when I think of like kind of the worst stuff that I do, like it's not like the kind of stuff that would get a warrant put out for me. Yeah. So yeah, weird dream set. And you know what? I can't explain it. I don't know where it came from. I do know where it came from watching a bunch of Rob Dyke videos. I was watching tons and tons of why would you put that on the internet? And some seriously strange. And because of that, my dreams were filled with weird stuff. Some seriously strange stuff. Okay. I'm down to 11 drivers in queue again. So this is 11 drivers ahead of you. That's 11 in queue. So let's hope that that Lyft doesn't try to screw me over again and take me out of the queue. What was that? How many was? Yeah. So it went from 7 to 33. Was it added 25? Yeah, that's ridiculous. So if I get another fare, not from where I'm supposed to, from friggin' Reston or Herndon, I'm gonna have to take it. Otherwise, I'll be knocked back 25 spaces in queue. That's ridiculous. Lyft, get your crap together. Honestly, what is wrong with you? This is garbage. Absolute garbage. I am in the queue. Get your crap together. Oh my gosh. So, you know, and I'm trying to enjoy myself. I'm trying to be the friendly Lyft driver. I even got told that again today. Like, yeah, you're so friendly. That's why I like to take Lyft over Uber, because Lyft drivers are so friendly. And you know, that's cool. But when you guys screw me over with taking away the bonuses that I like and replacing them with BS bonuses that I do not like, I've made it very clear, I do not like the bonus system that you have. It makes it hard for me to be the friendly Lyft driver, okay? You know, and I'm trying to peacock here as like the cool friendly Lyft driver guy, and yep, screw me over on stuff. It's a little frustrating. It really kind of hinders that.
So I want to just throw that out there that I love you, Lyft. I love what you let me do, what I get to do, but you got to get your crap together. Oh my gosh! All right, this is Gunsully for the podcast, The Indefensible Middle Ground, and I am signing off. I want to encourage everybody to. Support your Lyft drivers out there. Give them a 5-star rating. Give them a tip. If they're not a 5-star driver, give them tips like tips on how to be 5 stars. Give them 5 stars, and hopefully they'll improve. Okay, let them know. Like, listen, I'm gonna give you some tips. So This has been this week's episode of Lyft versus Crazy Taxi, and listening to some of my favorite local bands and the Slants. Got to throw the Slants in there because we definitely listen to them. And this right here, you hearing that? Are you jamming out with this? This is Chris, This is my friend Chris. But this is his band, Dr. Badlove and the Remedies. And I can't wait to interview him because I want to ask him if he is Dr. Badlove or if Dr. Badlove is more of a concept. And if he is Dr. Badlove, where did he get his medical credentials? Okay? That's a very serious question. All right, this is Gunsully for the podcast, The Indefensible Middle Ground. And in my own way for Lyft, I'm now 9th. I now have, well, 10th in queue. I have 9 drivers ahead of me. And, I want to reiterate, let me do a shout out to, all the bands that I featured in this: Fellowcraft first, then the Slants, then, Dr. Badlove and the Remedies, bands that I've given a shout out to: VOLTHEQUE, Future Computre, and Overcoming Gravity. So, Dead End Kidz. So, links will be in the description below. Love you all. Keep talking it out. Cheers.